Hey everyone, James Murphy here. This is mCoding, and let's just jump into it with some controversial events happening in the world of Python. If you haven't already heard the news, the CPython developers just pushed out a breaking change to the language, modifying long-standing behavior of how int-to-string and string-to-int conversions work, putting a default limit on how many digits are allowed. Previously, there was no limit on the size of integer you could use, as long as you have enough memory to hold it. This was one of the cool features of Python that new programmers would often explore. Just print math factorial of 10,000, and there it is. But if you download Python today, instead you'll be greeted with an error telling you the answer is too big. The default limit is 4,300 digits. Users must now call this sys setIntMaxStirDigits to increase the digit limit or set it to 0 to disable the limit. Now it prints just as before. This limit only applies to conversions from int to string and string to int that aren't in a base that's a power of 2, so printing binary and hex are not affected. But humans normally write numbers in base 10, so this does affect the most common use case. Also note that this is not a limit on the size of integers outright, only on conversions to and from strings, so you can still operate on big numbers without any changes, you just might not be able to print the results. That's why the error here is on line 4, where the print statement is, and not on line 3, where the answer is actually computed. Part of what makes this so controversial was that this change, which undoubtedly breaks some existing projects, was pushed out with essentially no warning to the community, not just to the latest development branch of Python 3.11, but to Python 3.7, 3.8, 3.9, and 3.10 as well, in a patch release. Patch releases are generally meant to be made of small changes that are completely backwards compatible or that fix outright bugs, errors, crashes, or security vulnerabilities. As such, tooling such as automated test runners may use the latest patch by default, and package managers may ignore the patch number when considering version compatibility. This means that projects depending on the old behavior will have their automated tests broken, and their users who are on the latest patch will immediately start experiencing these breaking changes, even if the project hasn't made any new release. So why would they push out a breaking change like this? Going to the CPython source, this GitHub issue claims the previous behavior of int string conversion is a security vulnerability, which explains why it's able to be pushed out so quickly, even though it was a breaking change. This vulnerability was initially reported in May of 2020 and officially went public on September 1st, 2022, according to Red Hat's CVE page, although the GitHub issue was apparently created a month before in August. So what is this vulnerability? Well, CPython uses an n-squared algorithm in the number of digits for int-string conversions when the bases aren't compatible. Here, a mere 1,000,001 digits took 4.5 seconds to complete. We can confirm this n-squared behavior empirically by looking at the timing plots for conversions. We can clearly see superlinear growth in this plot. And if we look at a log-log plot and compute the least squares fit, we see that the estimated power is very close to 2. So, empirically at least, this really is an n-squared algorithm. Under the hood, the actual algorithm that Python uses is very similar to these basic conversion functions. It's really not much more than repeated division or multiplication, depending on the direction. These may appear to be just O of n algorithms, but it's actually O of n squared because multiplication and division are not constant-time operations since we're working with arbitrarily large numbers. So these divide by 10 or multiply by 10 are actually order n operations themselves. This means that converting between integers and strings is more expensive than you might expect, and it opens Python up to a denial of service attack on any code that tries to convert between them. In particular, any kind of parser or API that takes base 10 values as strings may be vulnerable, including the built-in JSON module, parsing libraries like Pydantic, and API frameworks that depend on these. A bad actor can send a moderately large number with, say, 1,000,000 digits to cause an API to freeze for around 5 seconds like we saw. The new default digit limit fixes this issue by raising an exception that your code can catch unless you have explicitly opted in to allowing this expensive conversion. Of course, primarily in favor of the change, there are operators and users of services that have these vulnerable APIs. The original GitHub issue argues that the change is necessary in part because of how incredibly common it is to take unsanitized user input from the internet and pass it directly to int. On the other side are authors and users of libraries that use big numbers, meaning this is probably going to hit math libraries the hardest. This may complicate things for their users, and of course, now the code that they've already put out there is broken. Some in this camp have argued that doing anything with unsanitized user input is already a vulnerability waiting to happen, so it should really be up to vulnerable APIs to sanitize their inputs, not the Python language to limit how numbers work. Others are confused why we're using these n-squared algorithms when there are known faster algorithms readily available. Potentially, switching to faster algorithms could make the denial of service infeasible, eliminating the need for the digit limit at all. And then, of course, there are a large number of people that are perfectly fine with the change as they're most likely not affected by it, but just upset by the lack of transparency or opportunity to have their opinions considered, and to potentially prepare for the break. Regardless of how this issue pans out, the core dev team did apologize for the lack of transparency on the issue, although it is sometimes necessary for security vulnerabilities. And they are welcoming further discussion on the issue. If you have an opinion on the matter, especially if you're affected by the change, the correct place to respectfully voice your opinion is the Python discourse, linked below. Please keep your suggestions and criticism constructive and don't use the discourse to rant. And that's where I pass it off to you. What do you think about this breaking change? Is protecting vulnerable APIs that you or I may unknowingly be using every day worth it? Even if that means some math libraries are broken? Or should vulnerable code be on the hook to sanitize its inputs? Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. As always, thank you to my patrons and donors for supporting me.